stud with a lot of experience behind him as well. A record that is most enviable. Traveled the world. He was in Vienna, Austria a little while ago, wrestled a German champion there and absolutely destroyed him.
He did.
Yes, he did.
Well, he'll never be asked to come back there again.
I don't think so. And that doesn't happen often either.
Arcidi certainly does not lack confidence of it.
No, he doesn't, does he?
He oozes of confidence. It's just oozing out of his body.
He's got a tremendous amount of experience.
Well, we finally get a finger grip lockup. And now both hands. The irresistible force meeting the immovable object.
Absolutely. Look at that 6'10" there. He's trying to use every inch of it to pick up the leverage and balance to overpower Arcidi.
Strutt seems to be getting the upper hand with that height advantage. He certainly did. Dropped Arcidi down to his knees. But Arcidi fighting back right now.
And he certainly has this Boston Garden crowd behind him.
They're cheering on the hometown favorite.
My goodness, that is a feat there in itself. He's on both feet.
Oh, now it's Arcidi with a downward pressure. Big John Studdall. He was about to go down. Instead, a well-placed knee drives Arcidi back down to the canvas once more.
Yeah, and I think Studs had that at the back of his mind all the time. He looks confident. He knew he had that little ace off his sleeve. See if he uses it again.
Arcidi's got that adrenaline flowing. Crowd here in the Boston Garden giving him everything he needs from their standpoint. Now it's up to you. And he's turned it over once more. But Studd very close to the ropes, so ring conscious at all times. And it's Studd who may go down. No, he blocked that knee and gave him one of his own. He's got the shot. Big John Studd grabs a hold of the ropes immediately. Oh, knee right between the eyes. Well, he came close to 15th foul, but he didn't get it.
He really did, and that's part of Studd's strategy. Use that tremendous distraction of $15,000 that nobody can resist and put that man into a place that is compromising. And now look what's happening, and Arcidi is certainly paying for it.
Studd unloading now with a heavy artillery. Those heavy forearms taking their toll. If I were Studd, I don't think I'd be hitting him in the pectoral area. That's his strong point. In the Boston Garden. But he hesitated for just a moment. And Studd is saying, go ahead, hit me. And Arcidi is obliging. Well, Studd back in control once again. And he's taunting the big guy from Beantown, saying, come on, hit me. He doesn't know how to get the leverage behind those blows up.
No,
if he did,
he'd have had Studd flat on his back and out. But Studd is pretty resilient anyway.
Three big right hands.
He's laying another one.
They're starting to take their toll. And Studd spins him around with a handful of hair. Oh, thumb right in the eye. Come on, referee.
Suddenly Studd was beginning to feel the power of those big forearms, and he decided it was better to do something about it than just taunt him.
Look out, Big Ted in for the ride. Wow, he hit right on an angle. Oh, right into the clothesline. There's where he should have went for the slam right there.
Yes. An ineffective forearm.
Off the ropes, big elbow on the back of the neck of Big John Studd. Look out.
Right out of the ring. Studd unceremoniously just
upon the apron, and John Studd waiting for him with open arms.
Yes, and he's saying there's plenty more where that come from. He's going to turn him around and beat his chest in now. Boom! Oh, he's saying to Arcidi, that's the way it's done.
Welcome to the real world.
Yes.
Big John Studd doing a number right now on that man right there, the world's strongest man, Ted Arcidi. Got to mount some kind of offense here very shortly, or Studd's going to take him right out of the picture.
He really will, and Studd is a punishing, punishing wrestler, and he knows just how to make a rookie like Arcidi pay for his mistakes. Well, Arcidi challenged him in his hometown, and Studd is not slow to point out to his own home crowd, or Arcidi's home crowd here, the faults and the chinks in the armor.
I wonder just how good, how in condition Arcidi is, whether he's in real top-notch condition, because if you run out of gas out there with Big John, he'll put you away. Arcidi now with both legs, dragging Big John outside with him. And both men now on the floor here in the Boston Garden. Rams his head into the apron. Referee laying the count now on both men. Arcidi's got something left.
He has, look at him. My word, look at Arcidi.
Big right hands, and John Studd begins on load again.
Oh, those massive forearms. Look at Arcidi. That's amazing.
And now John's going to run him into the steel post. Yeah. Post.
Fortunately, John was able to cover that a little bit with his arm. Arcidi, inexperienced there, didn't put his arms down. Otherwise, he'd have done a lot more damage to Studd.
Looks like World War III going on here. And they don't want to stop. The bell is rung. This match is over, but they don't care. Oh, look at that. Went to the well one too many times. Big John Studd just shoved him off there.
I'm afraid you don't catch John Studd that easily.
Arcidi wants back inside the ring. I don't think he knows that the match is over.
No, I don't think he wants this match to be over. He wants to show his own people here how he can deal with Studd.
Arcidi appears to me to be out of gas, Alfred.
Yes, I think he was. That took the sap out of Arcidi.
Studd's not coming back in. He's no dummy. Let's get the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has counted both men out of the ring. A double countout.
Well, we didn't really prove anything in this match other than Ted Arcidi could match strength with Big John Studd. Maybe the World Wrestling Federation matchup committee will see fit to make this a return match.
I'm afraid you don't catch John Studd that easily.
Arcidi wants back inside the ring. I don't think he knows that the match is over.
No, I don't think he wants this match to be over. He wants to show his own people here how he can deal with Studd.
Arcidi appears to me to be out of gas, Alfred.
Yes, I think he was. That took the sap out of Arcidi.
Studd's not coming back in. He's no dummy. Let's get the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has counted both men out of the ring.
Well, we didn't really prove anything in this match other than Ted Arcidi could match strength with Big John Studd.